Good morning to all. I am Subha Rani from Emmanuel Arasar College of Education, Attalam, Kanyakumari district. Today we are learning about the topic scheme implemented under NPE. The explanation of NPE or the abbreviation of NPE is National Policy on Education. The National Policy on Education was started on 1986. The National Policy on Education is a policy formulated by the Government of India to promote education amongst India's people. The policy covers elementary education to colleges in both rural and urban India. The second one is a sustainable improvement in the quality education to enable all children to achieve the essential level of learning. So, National Policy on Education is implemented in the year 1986. The National Policy order aim means the policy covers elementary education to colleges in both rural and urban India. Then, a sustainable improvement in the quality education. The National Policy's aim is mainly the quality education to give the rural and urban area. Then NPE implemented some schemes. The schemes are, first one, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, SSA, Operation Blackboard, OB, National Testing Service, NTS, and Navodaya schools. They have four implementation of schemes in NPE. First one is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan, then second one is Operation Blackboard, then third one is National Testing Service, and the fourth one is Navodaya schools. Then, the detailed study of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Our central government convened a conference of state educational ministers in Delhi in the year 1998, and they passed the resolution to implement a scheme for free and compulsory primary education for children all over India below the age of 14. The second point is, the resolution was made a bill and moved in the parliament, and it became law to implement the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan in the year 2000. So, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is implemented, started at in 1998. The compulsory primary education for the children all over India below the age of 14 is important points. Then, objectives of SSA. To admit children in India into schools who are above 6 year and below 14 year old. The first objective is to admit children in India into schools who are above 6 year and below 14 year old. Next point, to admit children in their primary schools first. Children to be given a bridge course for school education within 2003 under the Education Guarantee Scheme. Then, to give primary education to children who are admitted to school within 2007. To give primary education up to 8th standard for all children within 2010. Then to improve the standard of the primary education and to stress the life skill. Then education, the primary education itself. Next, to reduce the gender gap at the primary education level within 2007. Then to retain children admitted to the primary school until 2007. Then next objectives of anyone revise the objectives of SSA. First point is to admit children in India, in Indian children admitted to schools for above 6 year and below 14 year old. Then in primary school students first given a bridge course for school education within 2003 under the Education Guarantee Scheme. Then to give primary education to children who are admitted to school within 2007. Then the primary education up to 8th standard for all children within 2010. Then to improve the standard of primary education and stress the life skill education in the primary education itself. Then to reduce the gender gap at the primary education level within 2007. Then to retain children admitted to the primary school under 2010. Then implementation process of SSA. The enumeration of school age children has been done by SSA workers and it is continuing periodically. Then second point is SSA workers have been identifying and are giving as age properties short-term course for admitting them into the primary school. Then SSA giving periodic training to the primary school teachers in new teaching approaches under the help and guidance of SCERT and DIETS. Then SCERT means, the abbreviation of SCERT is State Council of Educational Research and Training. DIET means District Institute for Education and Training. The next implementation is eradication of dropouts in the primary school has been done continuously. Then SSA has implemented almost the construction of new schools or alternate school within 1 kilometer radius from the residence of the children. Then continuing the funding of schools created under the SSA scheme. The next point is, much focus has been given on appointing at least 2 teachers for a primary school. Focus has been given on appointing at least 2 teachers for a primary school. Then SSA has been giving rupees 500 per year for making teaching materials. Then SSA is giving education to the disabled children. Education give to the disabled children by admitting in the inclusive school. Only education for the disabled children by admitting in the inclusive school. Then SSA is giving in service training to school teacher within the block, through its block resource centers and cluster resource centers. Then implementation process of SSA is, the enumeration of school age children has done by the SSA workers and it is continuous periodically. Then SSA periodic training of the primary school teachers in new teaching approaches under the help of guidance of SCERT and DIETS. The eradication of dropouts in the primary school has been done continuously. SSA has completed almost the construction of new schools or alternate schools within 1 kilometer radius from the residence. Then continuing the funding of schools created under the SSA scheme. Then much focus has been given on appointing at least 2 teachers for a primary school. At least 2 teachers for a primary school, but compulsory one is female teacher. Then SSA has been giving rupees 500 per year for making teaching materials, teaching and learning materials. Then SSA is giving education to the disabled children by admitting in the inclusive school. Only disabled children contains inclusive school. SSA is giving in-service training to school teacher. SSA is giving in-service training to school teacher within the block, through the block resource centers or cluster resource centers, etc. Then Operation Blackboard. Second point is Operation Blackboard. First point revised in SSA, Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Second point is, second implementation of National Policy of Education is Operation Blackboard. This scheme was implemented in the year 1987-1988 for making infrastructure, supplying teaching learning materials and for appointing teachers in the primary school. So the Operation Blackboard system was implemented in the year 1987. It is the uses for making infrastructure, applying teaching learning materials and for appointing teachers in the primary school level. This scheme was implemented all over India with the central government aid, and the scheme was enforced till the SSA was launched in the year 2003. Then 5,22,902 primary schools and 1,38,009 middle schools were benefited by this scheme all over India. In all over India, 5,22,902 primary schools and 1,38,009 middle schools were benefited this Operation Blackboard scheme. So Operation Blackboard scheme was implemented in the year 1987 to 1988 for making its uses for making infrastructure, supplying teaching learning materials and for appointing teachers in the primary school level. This scheme was implemented all over India with the central government aid, and the scheme was the first till the SSA was launched in the year 2003. Then third one is National Testing Service. Third one is National Testing Service. All over India, the National Testing Service allows some institution to conduct examination for giving certificates for recruiting persons for the lectures post, for joining in research institute for finding skills of person and giving certificate to them in dress making, food processing, drawing, sculpturing, etc. and for making placements in these companies. Then, moreover, NTS enables joint common entrance examination for studying engineering and medical courses all over India. National Testing Service's important aim is common entrance examination for studying engineering and medical courses all over India. So, National Testing Service in all over India allows some institution to conduct the examination for giving a certificate, for recruiting persons for the lectures post, for joining the research institute, for finding skills of person and giving the certificate. To the mean, some topics, some subjects, dressmaking, food processing, drawing, sculpturing, etc. And for making placement in these companies. The important point is NTS enables joint common entrance examination for studying engineering and medical courses of over India, all over India. Then fourth one is Navodaya schools. Navodaya schools means Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalayas. It is a system of schools for talented students predominantly from rural area in India. Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya is a system of schools for talent. Only talented students are predominantly from rural area in India. Its significance lies in the selection of talented rural children as the target group and attempt to provide them with a quality education comparable to the best in the residential school system. So Navodaya school is Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya. Of this is a system of schools for only talented students. It is used in only talented students from rural area in India. Its significance is the selection of talented rural children as the target group and to attempt provide them with quality education comparable to best in the residential school system. Then the aims of Navodaya schools. To be model schools developing the qualities of education. Is the important aim of Navodaya school. Next, the second one is to import quality education. Without considering caste, religion and economic status of the students. Only give the quality education without considering caste, religion, economic status of the students. Then to remove the economic hurdles of the talented students by giving education free of cost to them. Then to teach children using modern teaching aids for bringing out the potential skills of the students. And to improve the quality of education, through the new teaching methods. The aims of Navodaya school is important one to improve the quality of education. Education quality is improved through the new teaching methods, new teaching technologies. To give freedom to the teacher to make innovations in curriculum designing and in new teaching methods. To give Navodaya schools to give a freedom to the teacher to make innovations in curriculum designing and in new teaching methods. Then to foster the quality, social justice and fraternity are our constitution among the students. Then to give a residential education to the students for learning to live cooperatively and for developing national integration and social harmony among them. To give the residential education and to live cooperatively. Then to create a model school with world standard. Then to share the resource with the schools nearby. To be accountable for teaching under the system of education. So the aims of Navodaya school is, first one is to be a model school developing the quality of education. Then to impart quality education without considering the caste, religion and economic status of the students. Then to remove the economic hurdles of the talented students by giving education free of caste. To teach children using modern teaching aids for bringing out the potential skills of the students. Then to improve the quality of education through the new teaching method. The quality of education is improved, then include the new teaching methods and new technologies. then to give freedom to the teacher to make innovations in curriculum designing and in new teaching methods. Then to foster the quality, social justice and fraternity or our constitution among the students. Then the foster the quality. Quality, social justice and fraternity are our constitution among the students. To give the residential education to the students for learning to live cooperatively and for developing national integration and social harmony. Then to create a model school with world standard. To create a model school with world standard. Then to share the resource with the schools nearby. To share the resource with the schools nearby. Then to be accountable for teaching under the system of education. Salient features of Navodaya schools. First one, in these schools, CBSE syllabus is formed. In the Navodaya schools, only CBSE syllabus is followed. These are co-education schools. Navodaya schools are co-education schools. Then free education with a free uniform and residence is given for students from the 6th standard to 12th standard. Free education with a free uniform and free residence is given for the students for the 6th standard to 12th standard students. Admission is done by conducting entrance exam. Only admission is done by the entrance exam only. Seats allotment for done for SCST students. Only SCST students seats are allotment. 40 students are admitted to each class. To each class only 40 students are admitted. National common curriculum is followed. The national common curriculum is followed. Then students can study their subjects through the mother tongue till 8th standard. Students can study the language or subjects through mother tongue till 8th standard. Teachers working in these schools are recruited by the National Testing Service examination conducted all over India. In all over India, a test is conducted. The test name is National Testing Service. Only the eligibility of National Testing Service examination, the teachers are working in the Navodaya schools. In each Navodaya schools, only 20% of the students are from other states. In each Navodaya school, only 20% students are from other states. The school is situated in area of 3 acres. The school is situated in an area of 3 acres. These schools are fully equipped with quality teaching and learning materials. The schools are fully equipped with quality teaching learning materials. So, salient features of Navodaya schools are, first point is, the schools are follow the CBSE syllabus. The schools are follow the CBSE syllabus. The schools are co-education school. The schools are co-education school. The free education and free uniform and free residence is given for students from 6th standard to 12th standard. 6th standard to 12th standard students only give free education and free uniform and free residence. The admission is done by conducting only. Admission is conducting entrance exam only. The seats allotment are done for SCST students. SCST students are they give the seats allotment for Navodaya schools. Then 40 students are admitted to each class. Only each class 40 students are admitted. National common curriculum is followed. National common curriculum is followed. Then students can study their subjects through the mother tongue till 8th standard. Teachers working in these schools are recruited by the National Testing Service. Teachers working in these schools, they are write a test for National Testing Service examination. It is the eligibility of Navodaya schools. The exam is conducted in all over India. In each Navodaya school, only 20% of students are from other state. In each Navodaya school, 20% students are from Navodaya, from other states. The school is situated in an area of 3 acres. These schools are fully equipped with quality teaching learning materials. So, in which year the national policy on education is started? The national policy on education is started in 1986. So, the important aim of national policy on education is the policy covers elementary education to colleges in both rural and urban India. that the important points in NPE is the quality education, to enable all children then to achieve the essential level of learnings. The two important points in national policy of education. What are the two important points in national policy of education? First one is the policy covers elementary education to colleges in both rural and urban India. Then second one is the quality of education to enable all children to achieve the essential level of learning. Then what are the implementation scheme of NPE? The implementation scheme of NPE is four. First one is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Second one is Operation Blackboard. Third one is National Testing Service. Fourth one is Navodaya Schools. Then Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. In which year the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is implemented? Then Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is implemented in the year of 2000. Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is implemented in the year 2000. What is the main aim of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan? Is the free and compulsory primary education for the children all over India below the age of 14. The important points of Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan is the implementation of the Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan scheme is for free and compulsory education, free and compulsory primary education for the children all over India below the age of 14. Then Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan started in the year 2000. What are the important objectives of SSA? The first important objective is the admit children in India into schools who are above 6 years and below 14 years, and the primary school students, first children to give a bridge course for school education, to give primary education to children who is admitted the schools within 2007. To give the primary education up to 8th standard for all children within 2010. It is an important aim of SSA. Then to improve the standard of the primary education. Then to reduce the gender gap at the primary education level within 2007. Then to retain children admitted to the primary school until 2010. Then important implementation process of SSA is, first enumeration of school age children has been done by the SSA workers and it is continuing periodically. SSA giving periodic training to give SERT and diets. Then eradication of dropouts in the primary school has been done continuously. SSA has embraced almost construction of new schools or alternate school within 1 kilometer radius from the residence of the children. Then much focus has been appointing at least 2 teachers to a primary school. Then one is female teachers. Then SSA gives ₹500 per year for making teaching material. SSA giving education to disabled children with inclusive school. Then SSA giving in-service training to school teacher with block through its block resource centers. Then Operation Blackboard, it was started in 1987 to 1988. This scheme was implemented all over India. The central government aid and the scheme was forced till the SSA was launched in the year 2003. And there are 5,22,902 primary schools and 1,38,009 middle schools were benefited in the Operation Blackboard scheme. The National Testing Service all over India, the National Testing Service conducted an examination for giving certificates for recruiting person to the lecture post, for joining in research institute for finding skills of persons, to give some certificate courses are dressmaking, food processing, drawing, sculpturing, etc. Moreover, the important points in NTS is first a common entrance examination for studying engineering and medical courses. Then Navodaya schools, Jawahar Navodaya Vidyalaya schools are talented students predominantly from rural area in India, aim to be a model school developing the qualities of education, to teach children using modern teaching aids and bringing out the potential skill of the students. To impart quality education without considering caste, religion, economic status, to give freedom to the teacher and the quality, to foster the quality, social justice and fraternity of our constitution, to create a model school with a world standard, to be accountable for teaching under the system of education. Salient features of Navodaya schools in it is the syllabus is conducted in CBSE syllabus. It is a co-education school, a free uniform, free education, free residence with standard 6 to 12. Admission is done by conducting entrance exam. Seats are available in SC, ST students. 40 students are admitted in each class. National common curriculum is followed. Students can study their subjects through the mother tongue till 8th standard. In Navodaya school, 20% students are from in other state. The school is situated in area of 3 acres. The schools are fully equipped with quality teaching learning material. So today we are studying many topics. National, what is the definition of national policy on education? The scheme implemented under national policy education. First one is Sarva Shiksha Abhiyan. Second one is Operation Blackboard. Third one is National Testing Service. Fourth one is Navodaya schools. Okay, thank you, students.